It's been a rivalry that's built for 20 plus years.
Trent Reid!
Oh, this is a magnificent game of football.
Edge of the seat. Listen to the roar.
Every letter is love and every word's in our way.
These two teams have a history of success.
You're damn right. We've been working the late shift, trying to see how far on planet Earth we can take it. This is poetry in motion, the mystery of why. Every motor is in motion and it's visually divine. On a roll like Timmy, and they're stuck in bad traffic. So when I rock at the bottom, looks like Buckingham Palace.
God damn, it's spectacular. Rock it up and low with that flip of the tongue and hit of the drum. Rockin' and roll, yeah. I spark an idea ignited from my balls. Added to the 99 bottles of lightning on my wall. In a bowl of hope on an ocean where the sharks live. Spitting fireflies to paint my poems in the dark. Connected with me is in the stare. Electricity is in the air.
More history will be made. But who will make their way to the big dance? Get ready for one fiery clash. This is finals footy. This is a prelim final. It's Port Adelaide versus Richmond.
What's going on, Port fans? Welcome back to another video on my channel, and today we're going to be previewing the 2020 preliminary final between Port Adelaide and Richmond at the Adelaide Oval. Friday night footy, 7:20pm start, and I tell you what, this is what we've been waiting for. This is what we've been grinding day by day to get to this position, a chance to solidify a spot in the grand final. Our first grand final since 2007, and a chance at a premiership for the first time in a long, long time. And the excitement levels around South Australia at the moment are beyond belief. And it's great to see so much colour and passion coming out of the fans and everywhere around Adelaide at the moment. You just see black, white and teal. And I tell you what, Richmond, the reigning champs, are coming across. Well, from Queensland. They're coming down. Their fans are ready. And they are coming with a full steam ahead because they would be full of confidence coming up against a Port Adelaide side that no one has rated all year. And we're finally in this position where we've got a chance to knock off the champs. So, this is it. This is the preliminary final. And I'm very much looking forward to previewing this one. But first, let's kick off this preview to go with our Richmond correspondent, Mr. Jordan Werfel himself.
Hey, Pair fans. It's me again. Obviously, back with another prediction. You know what happened last time. Didn't work out too well, but hopefully prelim this week, it's a big game for the boys. Obviously, there's a lot of comparison with last time we played. The list is a bit different. We had a lot of outs. Obviously, you know, you guys had a few as well. But in the grand scheme of things, obviously, I'm going to say our list was quite depleted at the time. But I'm not going to predict against us. Obviously, I want the Tigers to win, make another grand final for third in 4 years. I'm going to say that I think it'll be a good game, but I think we'll do what we did in 2017, blow teams out in the last half, last quarter specifically, and the Tigers will get up by 22 points. Cheers.
Thank you to Jordan Werfel, our Richmond correspondent there. He's looking a bit nervous, I reckon. And as we all are as fans, we're getting closer. We're 24 hours or less away now from what's going to be a massive, massive prelim final. So let's get into this preview. It's the new kids on the block, Port Adelaide taking on the reigning champs. Port coming in with full of confidence, top of the table, knocking off a Geelong side that no one thought we'd probably beat at the Adelaide Oval. And now we've had a week off again. We're refreshed. We're ready to go. We're going to have an unchanged lineup this week. That's the key here. That's the unchanged lineup. No changes from the qualifying final. Marshall and Dersma have gotten up from their respective injuries. And we're coming up against a Richmond side that will no doubt probably go in unchanged as well. They've got full of confidence. And everyone's talking about, and Jordan Werfel mentioned this in his little feature there, was there was a lot of outs in that game in round 11 earlier in the year, and that's the game we've been talking about. You know, we matched it with Richmond with their pressure, and we were able to counter-attack their attacking play with our manic pressure, but also hitting the scoreboard. And I think Damien Hardwick did say the scoreboard flattered the Tigers in the end, and we probably shouldn't have let it get to a position where they were close enough to have a go. But with the outs that Richmond did have, and I've seen the outs, you know, I don't think they had Hooley, they don't think they had Koch and Graham. There's a few others that off the top of my head I cannot remember. Nan Curvis was another one. So their main ruckman, and now they're coming up against the Port side. Now, Port didn't have a couple of stars either. There was no Rosie, there was no Marshall, there was no Ebert. And there was a couple, I think Burton was out as well. So whilst, yeah, some would argue these players don't quite match up to the capabilities of the ones that Richmond were missing out, they do affect our structure. And Charlie Dixon was going lonesome with Pete Laddams. And we can see that with Pete Laddams in the side and Todd Marshall working well with Charlie Dixon, that they don't have to have a major impact on the scoreboard to allow us to hit other avenues at goal. Robbie Gray kicked three that day. Motlop and, well, Woodcock was playing. So it's that whole different dynamic that we'll have this time around. Both teams will have it, and no doubt about it, we'll go into this game thinking it will be a completely different game of football, and both have very similar styles of play. But I think it's just the way that the pressure that Port Adelaide and Richmond bring is what's going to make this game so enticing. And it's the better prelim of the two. You know, you've got Brisbane and Geelong who are up at the Gabba, and they both play similar styles of footy. And I think Port Richmond, it's going to be a very fast, very attacking, very pressurised game of football. And that's perfect for a prelim final. You win a prelim final, going into a grand final almost feels bittersweet, because the prelim is just as, if not more, important. You know, you go to a grand final, it's a singled out game. You've got a chance to finish your season with a cup. Right, that's the pinnacle. But when you go into a prelim, you're more nervous because you've got a chance to get to the grand final. You've got a chance to continue one more week. There's no tomorrow after this game. And that's what's so great about a prelim final. And for us to have an opportunity to host it at the Adelaide Oval in front of 27,000 fans on a perfect night of football, the conditions will be very good. It's going to be dry. It's going to be quite warm. So it's going to be who can make the most of their opportunities. And we saw in round 11, you know, Richmond had their opportunities. And so did Port. 13 goals, 15 we kicked. But we could have won by so much more. And when we saw in the first final between Geelong and Port that Geelong didn't take their opportunities, and look what happened. They fell away and Port were able to make the most of it. 9 goals, 4 Port kicked. We need to have another one of that. We need to have, you know, an 11 goals, 6 or a 12 goals, 8 or something like that that gets us across the line. Now, there's a stat here that I found out was quite interesting, is that every time Port Adelaide do score over 50 points, Port win the game in season 2020. Which for me is, you know, well, you look at it now, you score 50 points in a game of football and it's like, well, hang on, what, were you even playing a game of footy? How long was that? But, you know, 50 points, every time we've lost this year, we've scored under 50 points, and that's the goal. You know, that's 8 goals 2, 8 goals 3. Get to that 50 point mark. Now, we know Richmond are a very high scoring team. You saw that last week against St Kilda. They were able to hit the 80-point mark. And then their game against Brisbane, they were only kept to 50 points. So defensively, matching up, it's going to be quite interesting. Riewoldt, Lynch, you think Cleary goes to Riewoldt. McKenzie goes to Lynch. Jonas will probably pick up someone else in and around or help out as a third man up or something like that. And that's the other role as well I think Hamish Hartlett will get. And he did it so well against Hawkins. Yeah, Hawkins had 5 shots on goal and kicked one out in the full. But the thing was, we pushed him wide. And whilst he has a good set shot on goal, it was that structure of having Hartlett in front of that play that was pushing them wide and putting more pressure on the kick. And as we know, you put more pressure on the kick in front of 27,000 people that are Port fans, by all means, that's it. That is exactly what's going to happen. You're going to kick five behinds and you're going to have everyone in your ear, and it's going to affect you across tonight. And that's the same thing that's going to happen tomorrow night in the prelim, because honestly, there is so much riding on this, and it really doesn't sink in that it's a prelim final in the sort of year that we've had, you know, with the AFL, and you've had your stop-start football, COVID restrictions and everything that's happened. We're now at a prelim final and it doesn't feel like it. Yet at the same time, you think about the game. You continually, you know, I can't imagine what the players are thinking. I can't imagine what, you know, Richmond supporters are thinking in terms of, you know, this is another chance at a grand final for them. They're going to go into what is going to be their third grand final in 4 years. And this is a dynasty moment for them. You know, you look at the Hawthorn three-peat. You know, you look at Geelong's three grand finals in 5 years. This is what, you know, makes good teams great. And Richmond are already a great team, but they can make a dynasty here. There's a lot of pressure, I think, not inside the Tigers camp, coming from outside, because we're all expecting them to come out and be bullies. You know, they are a ruthless side. They have that aggression. They have, you know, not the type of aggression where Tom Lynch puts your knee in your head. It's more that aggressive nature attack at the footy. And for me, Richmond, whilst, yeah, Tom Lynch does what he does, and Trent Cotchin had that sling tackle, and, you know, all these things sort of build up, you start to hate the side, but it's a side you love to hate, and that's what makes a great side. And Richmond are coming into this one, they'll have full of confidence. You know, they'll back their play. It's all mental for this game. It's a prelim final. You know how good you can play. You've gotten to this position. You're not here by luck. Port finished the top of the table, not by luck, by keeping on winning. You know, and winning the games you should and backing it up week by week. And now you're at a prelim final. And this is a big week for both sides. But I think it's a bigger week for Port Adelaide. It is a bigger week for Port Adelaide. We've finally got to this position. You're in front of your home crowd. You finished top of the table. You've managed to get that monkey off the back, win a final. Ken Hinckley knows what he's got. We know what we've got. Richmond know what they've got, and they know what they're coming up against, and we're the same. It's a prelim final for the ages, this one, in a year where we've been affected by so much. I am proud that we're able to say we made a prelim final off the back of what we've had to deal with, and I'm sure Richmond supporters will say the same. That's why you come out of this one, you be no doubt devastated, but you also be proud of the performance that your team's put in. But in saying that, I'm going to give you my prediction, and I'm tipping that Port Adelaide are going to win this thing. We're going to take out this prelim, and we're going to head to the Gabba next week. And I'll tell you why. Because the Gabba needs power to play at night. Well, Port fans and Richmond supporters and anyone else that has been watching, that is my preliminary final preview. I hope it is not the last preview that I do this year for a Port game. I hope to see one more in me next week. But for now, let's focus on the prelim. I'm nervous now. We talked about it for 10 minutes and I'm shaking. Let me know in the comments below what you're thinking about this one. Who's going to win it? You know, who's going to stand up? This is a game that's got Robbie Gray written all over it. You know, we know how Dustin Martin plays. You know, Shai Bolton might step out of nowhere. Connor Rosie had a pretty quiet year, but does he make it a little bit louder with in front of the faithful and turn it on? You just never know. But it's made for anyone, this game. So I'm very, very excited. I look forward to being there, supporting the boys. Thank you so much for watching. Make sure you subscribe to the channel if you're new for plenty more Port Adelaide and AFL content coming your way for the rest of the year. My name is Anthony, and as always, gun the pair!